is my great honor and joy to be with you today in spirit as we celebrate of someone who changed his world and ours, Vincent de Paul. While embracing change can be very doubting, Vincent frequently expressed his amazement of what his followers had accomplished through positive change, saying, "Did you think of this? I certainly did not." 400 years later, Vincent would be even more amazed to see that his little company of followers had swelled to some 4 million, and that they so successfully took his mission of evangelizing the poor and being the change that impacts the lives of others. Today's Vincent's zeal and the determination of his followers to create a path to change can be seen in more than 160 branches of his family, who serve in 158 countries. How did all this happen? Obviously, through Jesus Christ, but also through a culture of vocations. While Vincent would not have used the phrase culture of vocations, he still would have recognized the process he set in motion. He not only pointed out to others the spiritual and physical needs of the marginalized of his day, but he was committed to serving and organizing others to join his efforts. In effect, he established a culture of vocations by modeling a mission. In other words, Vincent would not be amazed. He reminded his contemporaries that they were not who they once were and would eventually become. As you gather in the Miraculous Medal Shrine in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, I think of another Vincent. More than 90 years ago, Father Skelly was asked to raise money to build a much-needed seminary. It was natural for him to turn to Mary for guidance and for inspiration. As his own mother once had told him, "Wear this medal always." The medal was the Miraculous Medal, entrusted to a young novice seeking to commit herself to a Vincentian aligned life of serving the poor. Like Vincent, Father Skelly would also have been amazed at what he set in motion. Today, the association he founded has evolved to continue and expand his mission through new ways of communications, as evidenced by the Shrine's 3 million Facebook followers. He would also clearly see such technology as a vehicle for the mission of bringing good news to those who are on the margins. Towards the end of his life, Father Skelly was adamant that the association he founded and nurtured was not his work, but Mary's. Like Vincent, he too would say that we are not what we once were, nor what we will become. On the feast of St. Vincent de Paul, let us commit ourselves to recognize the needs of the forgotten, to committing ourselves to Mary, and to not only sharing the good news, but being the good news. If we are the good news, we will create for sure a culture of vocations. Only Providence knows what that will be in the future. I offer my special blessings to Father Michael Carroll, director of the Shrine of Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal in Philadelphia, the leadership and all the members of the Central Association of the Miraculous Medal in Philadelphia, as well as I would like to reach to all those who are following this live broadcast of the celebration of the Feast of St. Vincent de Paul, to remain open, or to ask for the grace to be open to Jesus' call for the mission he's entrusting each one of us to fulfill on earth, in this world, here and now. May St. Vincent's spirituality and charism inspire us to dedicate our lives to announcing in words and deeds the good news to the poor, as laypersons or as persons in consecrated life, sisters, brothers, priests. May Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal, St. Vincent de Paul, all the blessed saints and servants of God of the Vincentian family intercede for us.